Walk Through My Door by Anthony Bryan. Whatever, my soccer mom minivan rocks. Now, since I didn't welch on our bet and I did exactly what I was supposed to do, do I get my prize? I knew exactly what she was referring to, but I couldn't give in that easily. And what prize is that? I asked. She placed the tip of her index finger on my chest and slowly dragged it down my button line as she said, I want my longer than necessary lingering hug. I stepped even closer to her, placing my hands on her hips and slowly sliding them around to her back. I moved in until our bodies were pressed together. As I grabbed her tightly around her lower back, she wrapped her arms around my neck. We both pulled the other in tight and just held one another in the vacant parking lot. Lauren started to release her grip, and I pulled her tighter and whispered in her ear, "Not yet." She responded only by hugging me tighter than I had been hugged in a very long time. I softly kissed her neck, and I kissed again, only slightly higher towards her ear. Then I gently kissed her cheek, inching closer to her lips with each kiss, until she suddenly turned her head for our lips to delicately meet. I tenderly kissed her lips as I brushed my thumb along her cheekbone. I don't think I was able to kiss her lips more than 3 or 4 times before we erupted into a passionate, beautiful kiss. I felt like I was on a plummeting roller coaster with my stomach dropping as our tongues met for the first time. Never in my life had I felt a kiss like this, and the intensity grew with each fleeting second. She placed her hands flat against my chest, touching me as our lips and tongues drove each other wild. I lowered my hand and groped her through her dress. I realized we were in an open parking lot, but my lust commandeered all control of my senses. I placed my hand under her dress and firmly caressed the back of her leg until I reached her smooth ass. I slid my hand under her panties, and she raised her knee, rubbing the inside of her thigh against my leg. "Adam, I want you," she softly groaned. Squeezing the grip my hand had on her ass was my only response, and my other hand, which was on her ribs, moved up to her breasts. "Oh my God, I want you," she groaned again. "But I can't." "Don't do anything you aren't ready for," I reluctantly said. At that moment, I wanted her more than anything, but I also didn't want her to do anything she wasn't fully comfortable with. I wanted her badly, but I also wanted her to take her time. "I'm sorry, but I'm married." "But you're separated, aren't you?" "Yes, I am," she said. "But I'm still married. I want this to be right in every way. There's something about you. I don't know what it is, but there's something about you that just feels so right. Everything about you feels right, and I really don't want to risk ruining this." "There's something about you too," I told her, "and I definitely don't want to fuck this up." "Thank you," she said with a sigh of relief, but I like the way I worded it a little bit better. "You say tomato, I say tomato," I said, now realizing that the line made a lot more sense in a verbal dialogue than it does written here. I went on. "Can I just ask you one thing?" "You can ask me anything, Adam." I gave her a devilish smirk and a sly wink as I asked, "Would a blowjob fuck this up?" "Something else," she chuckled. "Remind me again why I like you?" "Aha! You are admitting you like me." "I do, a lot," she whispered with a final soft kiss on my lips. "But I'm about to turn back into a pumpkin, as you so eloquently put it. Even though I think it's the carriage that turns into the pumpkin and not Cinderella." "You're seriously correcting me, Miss Livingstone?" "Good night, Mr. Smartass," she said as she opened the door to her minivan and sat in the driver's seat. "Good night. Text me when you're home so I know you're safe," I said as I closed the door for her. I started walking back to my own car, and I wasn't more than 10 or 15 feet from Lauren's minivan when she lowered the window and called to me. "Adam!" She paused for a moment and continued, "I like you," as I looked back to her. "I like you too, Lauren." I got home and set my keys on the kitchen counter just as I received her text. "I'm home safe. Can't wait to dream of you. XOX. What an amazing night," I thought. What an incredible and fucking amazing night.